Hello everyone, welcome to the Neuromatch Academy. I am Zheng Wei. I'm a postdoc in Zach's lab at Baylor College of Medicine. I am one of the content creators and created the tutorials for the Optimal Control Day. I hope you enjoy them. Thank you.
Welcome to your Optimal Control tutorials. The question that we'll answer today is, how should the brain act? We'll talk about the perception action loop, where an observer gets to make measurements of the world and take actions accordingly in such a way as to maximize their expected value. This involves having an internal model of how the dynamics of the world work and what is valuable for the agent. Now we can characterize the model of the variables that are relevant here by that bigger diagram, which includes the world state evolving over time in blue, the measurements that are emitted by the world state that then update the beliefs, which are updated dynamically from past beliefs and ultimately drive your actions. And once again, the world state determines the actual observations, the utilities that you get, and the actions tell you the actual costs. So MDPs, Markov decision processes, are really interactive Markov models. And you covered Markov models in Tuesday. POMDPs are interactive hidden Markov models. On Wednesday, you found the posterior of current states using the measurements, and we used two running examples, the telegraph process, which is a binary HMM, and the continuous process, which we use the Kalman filter for. Now today, you will take actions based on those HMM inferences. There's a distinction between open and closed loop control in optimal control, which is dependent on whether you get to make measurements of the current state. Open loop, you solve the MDP under the assumption that you don't ever know what the future will hold. You just have to make a guess based on your starting point. On the other hand, if you keep measuring what the world is doing as you take actions, this allows you to have closed loop control. So we will consider both of these in the tutorials. First, we'll do fishing. This is going to be our example for a binary latent variable or a binary POMDP. And this will continue from your binary HMM from yesterday, and it will connect to reinforcement learning for tomorrow. The other example in tutorial two will be flying, where we will use linear dynamics and a linear continuous state with Gaussian noise. And that will continue from the Kalman filter that you learned about yesterday as well. So now we'll begin with tutorial one, gone fishing. The setup here is that you're trying to catch fish, and there's a school of fish which swims back and forth between the two sides of a dock. And when you're on the right side of the dock, you catch a lot of fish, but then when the fish move, now it's rarer for you to catch the fish. On the other side, you can move over, and now you catch more fish until they decide to leave again. And so your control task is to find out where you should be at any given time. When should you stay on one side, fish longer, and when should you switch? How should you do this? Well, this is an optimal control problem. Where should I go to catch the most fish? And the goal here is to maximize the total expected utility, which is really the reward minus the cost. And in order to define that problem, we have to define the states, actions, dynamics, and utility. The state space that we'll choose in this problem is two state variables, the position of the fish and the position of you. Both of them could be on the left or the right. And you get to control your own position. You can stay or switch sides. Now, switching sides costs energy, and we can measure that in units of fish. Now, the dynamics are going to be dictated by a telegraph process, which we've studied earlier as well. This says, what is the probability that the fish are on the left, given that the fish were on the left one time step ago? And we can say that the staying probability, P stay, is, let's say, 0.95, and the switch is 1 minus that, or 0.05. Now it's your turn. Look at the dynamics that emerge from this telegraph process and plot it as a function of different probabilities of staying on one side. We've given you the code for this. All you have to do is put in the values and see what the dynamics look like.